strollers, babies, breastfeeding pillows. Usually women walking around the Capitol like this are tourists, not activists.
Hey, hey, ho, ho, toxic chemicals have to go.
But moms like Lisa Allen came from all over the country pushing to regulate chemicals in products we all use, like mattresses, carpets, and plastics, even items made for babies that could be health hazards.
As a mom, it's overwhelming. You know, we do the best we can, but we still need help. We're hoping that our senators will help us to protect our children.
Earlier this month, the Chicago Tribune reported flame-retardant chemicals in many carpets and couches pushed by the smoking industry to prevent fires are also toxins that could cause cancer, fetal impairment, and fertility problems. That prompted this protest.
Every time you sit down on the couch, you know what happens? When you sit down, you release this fine spray of toxic chemicals right in the face of your baby.
That's not right.
That isn't right.
At issue, a 1976 law giving the EPA authority to regulate chemicals is in need of an update. The EPA administrator says because of legal and procedural hurdles, of the 80,000 chemicals in its inventory, the agency has tested just 200 chemicals and has only banned 5 because of toxic health risks. Senator Frank Lautenberg authored legislation to make testing more frequent and information more available, require manufacturers to provide on health hazards for all chemicals, and require chemical companies, just like pharmaceuticals, to demonstrate product safety before putting products on the market.
Require chemical makers to prove their products are safe before they end up in our children's bodies.
The chemical industry strongly disputes the EPA numbers, but insists chemical companies agree safety laws need to be updated. It's just the Democrats' approach would hurt businesses.
It will not do the two things that we really need to do. The two goals are to protect health and the environment, and also to ensure that American manufacturers can compete in a global marketplace.
But moms like Christine Neinstedt, who flew in from Idaho to talk to her senator, says she just wants information to make smart choices about what she buys.
You can't read a label on this pillow and know anything other than it's supposed to confer with, rules for fire retardants. That makes you feel like you're doing something safe for your family. It just turns out we've learned that the exact opposite may be happening. So until the labels mean something, we are powerless.